Hello, everybody. Welcome, welcome. It's 2017. Can you believe it? Ah, yes, we made it. 2017. So how's everybody today? Hey, Michelle. Hey, Petka. Aunt Beck. Hey, Dorothy. Here's Barb. That's right. Thank you for the introduction, Aunt Beck. Hi, Judith. Hello, Ina. You like my shirt? It's in honor of the sponsors. I forgot I had this. It's in honor of our sponsors. And here is one side. And see if I can show you. Can you see the other side? We have cats coming and going around here. Hi, Ruth. Hi, Naomi. Naomi. Ah, listen to me. Hi, Ruth. Hi, Miriam. Hey, Dana. Nice to see you. Nice to see everybody. Patty. Hi, Angel Art Studio. Uh-oh. And the technical department is making his presence known, which means illegal fluids must be safely stowed and in an upright position at all times. Oh, Dorothy's sniffling. Oh, no. Hi, Margaret. Hey, Lisa. You're here for the beginning. Yes, you are, Lisa. Hello, Barbara. Hi, Shelley. Linda. Hey, Linda. Nikki Beauty Bliss is in the house. That girl streamed for 31 days. She's a rock star in my world, I'll tell you. I can't do it. I couldn't even begin to think about doing that. She streamed for 31 days in a row. Yes, she did. Yeah, my fluids, my table, do as I please. Right. If you guys believe that, you're crazy. If you think he means that, no, 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 he does not. He doesn't want to fix it. That's his deal. Hey, Michelle. She's adorable. Nikki Beauty Bliss is adorable. Yes, she is. She is. Hi, Jan. Yeah, if you guys didn't see, on the 31st, it's recorded, so you can go to Nikki Beauty Bliss's channel, and you can see Race, who is the technical department, putting her makeup on her face. That was brave of Nikki. Very brave to let him do that. And he didn't do a half bad job, I have to say. Well, Linda, hurry up and get your coffee, for crying out loud. Jan Terry says, Nikki, your expressions were priceless during the makeover. He did do a pretty good job. Hi, Allie. Istanbul. Holy mackerel, welcome. That's a long way to come to watch me. Istanbul, I think you are the very first person to ever come from Istanbul to watch me. That is great. The internet's amazing, people. It's amazing. It's Nikki Beauty Bliss, N-I-K-K-I. Maybe the technical department will put it in for you. N-I-K-K-I, Beauty Bliss. And, oh, thank you, Allie. You are welcome. Allie says that she loves what I do and that she's thanking me for inspiring her. It is my pleasure. My pleasure. Aunt Beck is reminding everybody to like and share. Thank you so much for that. Allie says she loves what I do, and she made some artwork the other day. Good for you. I would love to see that. If you follow me on Twitter, at Barb Owen Designs, you are welcome to tweet photos of what you do to me on Twitter, because I love to share those with my followers. That'd be great. Hi, Vicky. Hi, Kat. Nice to see you. Let's see. Okay, I'm going to not do that name right. I'm going to guess. Silkina? If that's not right, correct me. Allie made paste paper. Good for you. That's great. Hi, Angelica. Oh, if you haven't done paste paper, you need to do that. Debbie Boring is in the house. Trouble. That Debbie Boring started a Kickstarter campaign or a GoFundMe or something to save the ugly woman. If you guys didn't see that, yeah, she did. Her goal was $10, and I don't think she even made it. That tells you the ugly woman is going to, yeah, the ugly woman is history. What can I say? Nobody wants to save her. No one wants to save her. Hey, Christine. Hello, Jan. The bears from up north. Hi, Kathy. Boy, we got a great group showing up here today. That is wonderful. Linda Donald, good to see you. Yeah, the poor old ugly woman. Nobody even wants to save her. Nobody wants to save her. I told you nobody wanted to save her. I told you that. You guys don't pay any attention to me. You don't listen to me at all. Not at all. Hi, Signa. And Dawn, hello. Hi, Sharon. It's buffering for you, Sharon. Yeah, it's stream health is yellow at the moment. It may straighten out. It's cold everywhere. Debbie wants to save her. Hi, Ilona. Debbie says she's going to give her a facelift. Good luck with that one. Hey, Lindy. Hi, Joy from Texas. Welcome. Well, we got a great group coming in. Hello, Petka. All right. So consider yourselves welcome. I'm glad you're here. And Happy New Year to everybody. It's 2016 was a great year in many respects. I thoroughly enjoyed it. Got lots of things accomplished. We're going to talk about some of those in a minute. And 2017 is going to be even better, right? So Happy New Year to everybody. I'm so glad you're here. And Debbie Boring says that she's going to alter the heck out of that. Hi, Rocky. welcome, everybody. I'm so glad you're here. Okay, so we're going to talk about 2016. But I just thought that sometimes I do magic. I don't know if you guys are aware of that, but sometimes I do magic. And so I have the biggest magic trick I've ever done, ever. And so I just want you to know that all the way from, I flew him in just by, you know, wiggling my nose. The technical department is actually not in California. That was just a big ruse. He's actually right here in my studio. So technical department, come on in. Ta-da!
I was sending a couple of things to the chat.
he's being so ornery. Surprise, everyone. This is the technical department.
Hey, everybody.
This is Race. Yes. Here we are. In the same space. And he's not doing my makeup. I'm just telling you.
Not yet.
Not doing my makeup. No, not.
You never know.
No, he would make me into a clown just because he could.
You never know. I have a whole bunch of paint back here I could use. Yeah.
Thank you for that.
Hi, everybody. Hi, Dorothy. Is that Dorothy, Ruth, Patty, Dawn, Petka? Hello, everybody.
Look at all that. Look at all that.
Nikki Beauty Bliss puts in a bunch of hearts. Hi, Nikki Beauty Bliss. I don't know. Lindy says on camera twice. Yeah, it was a long, long ride. Same shirt.
Yeah. Hi, Doris. I think I saw Krissa.
Hi, Doris.
I saw Krissa a minute ago. Krissa's here from Greece. We have Greece and Istanbul so far.
Wow.
And I don't know where all else. Oh, Israel. I know we have Israel. Hi, Carla. Caged Fish Carla.
Joy, Margaret, Katie. Miriam, everybody. Wow.
Munganana is Meg.
Munganana. Hi, Munga. Uh-huh.
Her name is Meg.
Hi, Meg.
Hi, Kasha. Kasha is all the way from...
Wow. Just reading the chat. It's crazy.
Yeah.
Ilona's all kinds of crazy people.
Well, yeah, Pavla's from the Czech Republic. Pavla, a.k.a.
Jennifer.
Yeah, that's right.
Jennifer's here.
Yes. Hi, Raquel. Flyover Pilgrim, Rebecca. Hello, Rebecca. Nice to see you from Virgin, Indiana. It ain't any better here, I'll tell you that.
No, it's cold here. It's warm in Los Angeles. What's the temperature, Nikki B. Bliss? I think it's, what, 70-something? I don't know. I
could look Pablo, at the thing. Pablo says, yay! that you remembered.
Yeah.
Krissa always does this. She always does these
icons. She does a bunch of...
She likes the icons.
Yeah, it's good. I like the icons, too.
She sends us love from Greece.
And it's...
Uh-oh, it's frigid in L.A. It's 60.
60 degrees, a little chilly.
Yeah.
It's a little nippy in Los Angeles. If it's 60 degrees, people start getting out their winter coats.
Yeah.
I have to do my pretty hair.
Do you?
Yeah, I have to do my hair. Make myself look presentable.
That's right. That's right. It's going to be 70 tomorrow, she says.
Oh, boy.
Yeah.
Oh, boy.
And Signa says it's -2 centigrade over here. Signa, where are you? Are you in the U.K.? And Pablo says it's 10 Fahrenheit now. Hi, Lynn. Good to see you, Lynn. Hi, Nancy.
Everybody's here.
Nikki Beauty Bliss says you're a diva.
I'm a diva? I'm sorry. Everyone needs to go to youtube.com/NikkiBeautyBliss and see who's the real diva.
That's true. So funny. Well, it's 28 in Istanbul. So far, we should go there. Baton Rouge, it's 36. Hi, Animal Lector. Oh, wait. I have my cheat sheet.
These are all the people?
Paloma. It's only the ones I can't remember. Animal Lector is Paloma.
This is your memory?
Yes. And Nikki's saying, no, stop it. She's not a diva.
No, never. Mm-mm. Ever.
Hi, Shirley. It's good to see you. She's in Alberta. Hey, Jess.
All kinds
of people.
I haven't
seen you in ages, Jess. Nice to have you pop in. 37 in Eureka, California. That's a little chilly. That must be up north.
That's cold for California. It's either high desert or somewhere in the mountains. I don't know where Eureka is.
Hi, Whippy Carol. Oh, that's funny. It's fun to see what the temperature is around the world. Okay, so anyway, well, consider yourselves welcome. I'm glad you guys are all here. Am I hogging too much? You can scoot over a little bit.
It's your show. You can do whatever you want.
Okay. It's so nice to have the technical department in the house. This is Race.
Hey, Christy.
Is Christy here?
She is.
Hey, there she is. Hey, Chris. That's my granddaughter. Christy's my granddaughter. So make her feel welcome. She has been here this week also visiting from down south, and so we've enjoyed her. And her boyfriend Tyler has been here, and Nikki Beauty Bliss is actually joining us in a few days, so she'll be here. So I'm telling you, it's just been a regular circus around here.
And we're thinking that Nikki Beauty Bliss and you might do a co-stream.
I've heard that was going to happen. So stay tuned. You need to follow me on Twitter, which is @BarbOwenDesigns. Follow me on Twitter. And because we will be doing, and also you'll get an email if you have followed me. What do they have to do? Click the bell on YouTube.
Oh, there's a bunch of ways. Yeah, there's a bunch of ways.
You can sign up. You need to get on the list so that you get the email. And also Twitter will tweet it out.
So the three ways are Twitter or under the video, there's a little bell. Just click the bell. Make sure that you get announcements. Whenever notifications, whenever you go live, or in the description, there's a link to sign up for our own private announcement email list.
Yeah. So you've got multiple ways, so you won't miss it. It could be interesting.
According to the chat there, she's thinking of a nice wig for you, Miss Barb.
Yes, and I did tell her that I wanted to try on at least one of her wigs. If not, if she brings several, I'm willing for her to put several of them on because I think it would be a riot. I think it'd be a riot.
According to Petka, is it Petka or Patty? Patty, it's too far away. She wants Nikki to make over the ugly woman. What do you think?
The ugly woman is beyond hope, people. She's beyond hope. Even Nikki Beauty Bliss cannot help.
I don't know. She works magic.
Yeah. And I've heard that that Nikki is going to teach me how to put on false eyelashes. This will be a riot. So you guys don't want to miss that. I don't know when we're doing it. So you're just going to have to stay tuned.
The big thing there is that we're not doing it on Friday next week. Because no. Nikki won't be here over Friday. She'll be here during the week. So you want to make sure you follow. So that if you want to catch that bonus extra thing, just make sure you follow.
Yeah. Yeah. Hi, Shirley. And anybody that I didn't say hello to, be sure that you know I'm glad you're here. And you're spending time in the studio with the two of us. And Clawsman is somewhere in the house. And he is monitoring the chat. So... Yeah, Shirley says false eyelashes. LOL. Yeah, I think that too.
Bigger the better.
Yes. Nikki, big long, I don't know, false eyelashes.
She knows the name.
You put them on. You put them on her.
I didn't put them on me.
No, but you put them on her.
Yeah, it's true.
One of them was a little...
The first one was not quite as glued enough because I didn't know how much to put on. The second one was perfect. Didn't come off for days.
Yeah. My favorite thing, when he was putting different kinds of powders on her face and stuff, he'd get it on there, and then he'd do this.
Knock all the dust off.
Yeah. It was a riot. It was a riot.
Didn't want to get too much. We'll go slowly.
Yeah. Yeah. Okay. So anyway. Hi, Janice. Hi, Sandra. Oh, goodness. Okay, so anyway, that could be entertaining, and that's supposed to happen sometime the early part of the week because she arrives on Monday, so it will either be Tuesday or Wednesday. It's one of those 2 days, if all goes well. Yeah. Wish me luck, people. Wish me luck.
You'll need it.
Pray for me. Wish me luck.
Well, the thing is, you can repay the favor by helping her do something crafty.
Yes, I think in the same stream that we should, I should have her paint a canvas and she can do my makeup. What do you think, people? What do you think, chat? Do you think that's a fair trade?
I hear that you might want to have her teach you how to wrap a gift.
Well,
because she doesn't seem to be very good at that particular task.
It is not a skill in her wheelhouse.
No, and we're not making fun because she did do a whole video on how to not wrap.
She did.
Christmas presents, if you go to her channel and have a look.
Yeah, if you haven't seen that one, that's worth a look too. And the thing about her gift wrapping skills is there's always one side that looks good, so you just put that side out. I learned that from her, and I appreciate that tip.
It's astonishing how many gifts actually get presented in wrapping and a bag.
Oh, yeah.
Because the bag is the savior of all of those
things. I can understand that. Yeah, I can understand that. I think she should invest in a significant number of bags, I do believe.
She's very talented at certain things.
She is perfect. But gift wrapping doesn't fall in that category.
No, unfortunately not.
Yeah. Yeah. Shirley says wrapping gifts that are terrible to wrap. Her husband does it because he's so fussy. See, I'm going to tell you what she's really trying to do. She's really trying to get you to wrap all the gifts. By doing such a crappy job, then you'll take over and do it.
Well, I mean, it's a good try, but I let her wrap what she wants to wrap.
Okay.
Go for it. If that's how you want to present yourself to your gift, that's fine.
Hi, Michael. Yeah, oh, that's funny. Okay, so, hey, how about if we do a review?
Do a little year in review?
Yeah, year in review.
Is that what we're going to do today?
I'll do one, you do one. You just may be making some art before it's over with.
Great.
He's
so excited.
Mm-hmm. We did do that one time. We did a stream where he did some art with me. He wasn't very happy about it. So
I did the snowflakes.
Yeah. Yeah, you did. And you did a really fine snowflake. That's when we were making sweet petals. And so as an interim, I taught you how to make a snowflake. You did a good job.
Yeah. Wasn't too bad.
He does everything better than he thinks he can. Okay. Oh, thanks, Shirley. Shirley likes my sweater. Yeah, Shirley likes my kitty sweater. Okay, so I'll do one and you do one.
So the idea is what we're going to do here is talk about what happened in 2016 mm-hmm. For the channel, for you, for everybody here, benefit for everybody, mm-hmm. What you did, what you feel good about, things mm-hmm. like that. and then what we've got planned for coming up in 2017. So you just know what's coming for all the cool new fun stuff as well.
Yeah. Yeah. Because when I started making a list of the stuff we did in 2016, I got done with it and I said, I am really tired.
Yeah. I did. It's a reasonable sized list.
It is. Okay. So I'm going to tell you that one of the cool things we did in 2016 is we completed seasons 2 and 3 of the member classes over at HowToGetCreative.com. Each one of those has 12 episodes in a season. So, and there, each of those classes is a recorded video class. Some of them, the goal to begin with is that they would be an hour long, and I don't think I've made an hour yet, have I?
For what?
For any of the
classes. No, they're all longer. Yeah. They're significantly longer.
Yeah,
the idea was that they would be an hour long, and they'd be in and out with the technique, but what, they're an hour and a half, almost 2 hours mostly.
Yeah, yeah. So I'm long-winded. What can I say? sing and play. Play music for us. No music will be played here today. No music at the moment. So anyway, yeah. So we have two seasons that we did during 2016. That was seasons two and three.
Yeah.
And although there are classes, we finished them up and got them all up for everybody. Although the classes are recorded videos, then we also include a full-length tutorial, photo tutorial with each one of them. So those are lengthy, and that way you can, if you don't watch the video but one time, you should be able to go through the tutorial and have that record, and you can go through and, you know, basically we want you to have the information in whatever way you want to have the information. You like it written down,
which
written. If you want it written, we have it written. If you want pictures, moving pictures, we got that too. Got you covered. Let's see, what's the chat saying? Hi, Joyce. She's at home watching today. Good. That's great. Hi, Alice from Nashville. No taping, no dancing. No. No, there won't be any of that. That's funny. You guys are great. Okay, so what else did we do? We started our special VIP classes.
Yeah, you did your VIP classes, and one of our special VIP, our VIP classes was for the VIPs.
Yes, for the VIP people, VIP members. And so we started those. We got those off and rolling. And
explain that just a little bit, what that is, because some people might not know.
The VIP is a very important person. The VIP members are members at the website, howtogetcreative.com, and because they are VIPs and joining under that membership, then they get some extra special things. One of those is the special monthly class, and it's a live class, which is really fun, you know, and everybody gets to come and participate. They can even be on camera. They can show what they've been working on and so forth. And then I always do a class for them as well. And there's several of the VIP members in the chat. So if you guys want to chat about that, tell people what you think, have at it. That'd be good.
Yeah, so it's kind of fun in that you get to do a one-on-one, but one to like a small class, like a small group.
It's like a personalized kind of thing. And the last time I did one, I was trying to thank everybody for, you know, telling them how much I enjoyed doing the VIP classes and spending time with them and all that. And I got all choked up and mushy and stuff. You know, it's like, that happens too. You guys know I'm a mush. Anyway.
Every once in a while, Coco, a little dog that lives with me, makes an appearance.
Yeah, yeah. Oh, Coco, he's funny. And sometimes he does tricks for us, so.
He often does tricks.
He does. He's a funny little guy.
Yeah.
Let's see, what else did we do in 2016? We did tips and tricks videos.
Yeah, you did a bunch of tips and tricks videos.
A lot of those. Those are small, not small, but they're shorter little, those are really technique driven, and so they're small, short things. But I've been known to do a tips and tricks video that lasted 30 minutes or an hour.
Yeah,
so.
Well, a tips and tricks video is supposed to be 10 minutes or less because it's just a tip or a trick, but sometimes you get a little long-winded.
I do. So if you guys...
They probably don't care.
If you guys that are members think that I should not be so long-winded, you'll have to tell me.
It adds up, though. A lot of stuff adds up.
Yeah.
Because you have to understand, everyone, that I don't know if I drive her to do this stuff, but I request or ask her to add another thing.
Let's
add another thing.
Okay.
And so she ends up adding all this stuff that does take time, but it's great. It's great and fun stuff.
Okay. Let's just.
So it's kind of my responsibility. It's kind of my fault that this stuff happens.
Yeah. Let's just review how this ever started. Okay. Let me tell you how this started. Way back in, 2012 or something?
Something like that.
He decided that he found out I was streaming, actually. I did that on the QT. I didn't tell him I was streaming. He had told me about streaming, and I didn't think I could do it. And then I saw some other people streaming, and I thought, well, that looks kind of fun. I'm going to try that. So I didn't tell him I was doing it. I went and bought my own camera. I just plugged it in and started doing it and figured out I could do it. This was, you know, way back. And he stumbled onto me, found me, and had been watching me for a while, I think. I didn't know it. And then he calls me up one day and he says, I want you to teach a class, an online live class. I'm like, you mean like the streaming thing? And he goes, no, I want you to do a multi-session class, like a course. And that... I'm going to tell you the truth. That thing that he pushed me into, and he pushed hard, almost caused brain damage.
It wasn't that bad.
Yes, it was that
well,
bad.
Well, you have to explain a little bit how it came about. Like, you had never done it, so it was very unfamiliar,
mm-hmm.
and you weren't comfortable with it.
And it wasn't easy.
It wasn't
the
easy
whole
for,
thing wasn't
it
easy.
Wasn't easy for a couple of reasons. Yeah. One, it was brand new. Right. And the second part of it, it wasn't done before you started the class. So, or liquids. The class wasn't done, so you were doing it one piece at a time, one week at a time. There wasn't another week already done.
Mm-hmm.
So this week was finished, and then it was a race to figure out what the next class was.
And
well,
we
don't
up,
do that anymore.
And I'd be up all night long the night before, putting finishing touches on whatever it was we were going to do. It was brain damage, people. It was brain damage. That's why I am the way I am today. But anyway.
Did you like it?
I did not.
Oh.
I did not. Until it was all over with. And then I had this huge feeling of accomplishment. And I was like...
So it was worth it?
Well, yes, it was.
Okay.
But during the process, it was brain damaging. It was. Anyway, that's how this whole thing started. And then he came up with this idea of, you know, moving forward with how to get creative, although I don't think it had that name back then. But anyway, it's been a long process. So anyway, as a result of that and all of this stuff going on, we released Mining Your Muse, which is a course. We released that this year. And by the way, any time that we do courses, anybody can take those courses. So you don't have to be like a special type member or something of the website to take the courses. We will sign you up as a, what do we call it? The limited member or whatever.
Yeah, you can have the course without a membership.
Yeah.
So it's a one-time thing.
Yeah,
instead of a monthly or instead of a long-term thing.
Right.
You can just have the one-time thing.
Right.
That's easy to do.
Yeah. So that was Mining Your Muse. We did that this year.
And that was the version 2 of the original part of that.
It was. The original version is what caused the brain damage.
Yeah. Probably still haven't recovered, have you?
Not totally.
No.
So in addition to all that, we've streamed, I counted up, at least 50 weeks that we've done this for you guys.
This year.
This year.
In 2016.
Yeah, but I've been streaming since 2011 or 10 or something. So,
right.
It's been a lot. Yeah. Yeah, Jan says, that's what kids do, push their parents out of their comfort zone.
I've never done that to you. What?
Hi, Sherry. I have no comment.
Right.
Okay, so that was 2016, kind of the year in review. So we're getting ready to go in 2017.
Hold on, before we do that.
Yeah.
Judith says 50 drama-free Fridays, right? Which is true.
That's true.
But the other thing we did that we don't have on the list here is that we put all of the old classes inside the members area.
The old streaming.
All the old Ustream stuff and even included all of the streams that we record live here on YouTube. They're also all in the members area for easy consumption. You can find them on YouTube for free as well, but that's not it's not a competition of where you can find it. Right. It's just we made it easy to find there too.
Yeah, we did do that. That was just a brand new thing here recently. A
couple weeks ago, maybe.
Yeah.
So that was kind of fun.
It was. That's great.
So are you looking forward to 2017?
I'm really excited about it.
Do you think do you think I might have something in mind for you?
Oh, God.
Because you did do this. I mean, you're so... You made it here. Might as well do something new.
Chat, what do you think? Do you think he has something in mind for me that could possibly... I want to have one of those great crazy things that they do. It's on Instagram where they do the thing with the faces, you know, where it goes. Yes. Yes. Do we think that he's going to do that to stretch me even further?
Maybe. Never know.
He hasn't really enlightened me yet, so let's just pretend that he didn't say that.
Well, there's a couple things on the piece of paper that we have planned, but there's some other things I haven't told you about.
Oh, yay. Oh, yay. I can't wait for that. Yeah, we have. Oh, yes. Oh, hell yeah. That was one of the responses.
Who said that?
Hell
I like
yeah.
her.
Katie.
Katie, I like you. Yeah.
Katie O'Party. Don says trouble brewing. Yes, of course he does. Yeah.
A couple of things that I have just planned.
Oh, wait. Linda, I like this one. Linda McAllister says that you're going to make coffee legal at the desk.
Okay.
Done.
Sure. Legal. Your wish is my command.
Yeah. Pardon me. Oh, that's funny. Okay, go ahead. What do you have planned?
Oh, just a quick technical note. We're going to make a couple of changes in the year next year sometime, where we're going to put in better cameras so that we can zoom in closer on the work so that you can see the detail in the work a lot better and more clear and really close. And you can zoom in and out.
And that really helps all of us.
Yeah, it helps everybody.
All of us.
The quality of the stream will go up. Mm-hmm. The picture will be better, but you can have the camera further away, but they can still see better.
And so the camera's not going to be...
Right, so you don't have this arrangement
where
anymore.
I have this.
We'll have it out where you don't have to have it. That's a technical thing, but it also will be a big advantage for everybody because what you're doing might be really detailed.
Right.
But we can have you zoom in on it.
So they can really see it.
And you can see it too, but everything is better. It's just easier to look at and it'll be nicer.
So that's coming. That'll
be sometime later in the year, but not happening right now.
Right. He's going to have to come back.
Right.
Oh, darn. He's going to have to come back and set all that up. Listen, people, I operate all this stuff. And if you saw the whole setup, which I think we've shown once or twice, if you see the whole thing and all the things that have to happen to make this happen, I'm telling you.
It's a lot.
It's a lot.
It's a lot of stuff.
So I don't have the patience or the technical knowledge or anything to put it together. I just run it.
Well, you don't necessarily have the knowledge on how to put it together, but you're really good at doing the thing. Yeah.
Could you say that again?
You're really good at running it. If we make you a little control panel. That's what this is. It's a little fancy thing, just so everybody knows.
Did you guys hear that? He said I was good at doing it.
Yeah.
I'm going to write. Wait a minute. Could you
write
that down?
You're going to write that down?
Could you write that? Here, I'm going to write that down.
Yeah, sure. Why
not? Here. Here, you write that down. Okay. I want it signed and dated because I'm going to need
You are good at doing it.
Oh, good. Oh, that's lovely.
There you go. See? Perfect. You're good at doing it.
It's taped. It's no need to write it down. It's recorded.
All right, it is recorded.
We have it. We have multiple witnessing situations. And it's witnessed by all these people.
All these people. Yep.
Yes.
Yep. Everyone saw it.
That's right.
Everyone in the world now can see it.
Oh, and Pablo says, Jennifer says she was like for you to write the coffee thing down as well.
The what?
The coffee thing about coffee.
Oh, the coffee. Yeah. Yeah, you want me to write that down too?
Jennifer.
Coffee is legal.
Jennifer, a.k.a.
Pablo,
yeah. Oh, my goodness. That's funny.
Okay, so that's the technical stuff. Now, you have some creative stuff that's really coming soon, that's on the front burner, not just the back burner.
Right. So the week of January the 15th we are going to start preview classes. That's something new and different. We're going to start preview classes that are going to be in the like the introduction to season 4 on HowToGetCreative.com. So that's something different. So that'll start the week of January the 15th. I won't tell you exactly which day yet, but it's going to start. It'll come out sometime that week. We're moving into season 4 with all kinds of fun creative classes. So I wrote down some of the topics that we have coming out. We're going to do a class about learning about color, color wheels, and color combinations. So it'll be all kinds of things about color. We're going to do a class on how to create a really fun folded book. It's an origami style book. It's a really fun, cool project.
That is really cool. You showed that to me last night, and that I didn't know that you could do that, but it's really neat.
He was even impressed. It takes a lot to impress him, I'll tell you. He was impressed. I'm going to do a class on all kinds of different ways to use zippers. And because in case you don't know, my attention span is not long enough to only do one thing. So I can't do just art journaling or just sewing or just fabric or just fabric paper or, you know, clay or, you know, whatever. I can't focus only on one thing because I get bored to tears. I can do all those things in a rotating kind of fashion, but I can't do just one of them. So that's why you'll see this eclectic mix of all kinds of things. After all, it is all about me, right?
Oh, for sure.
I don't know.
It's all about them. It's all about the chat.
It's totally all about you.
That is the truth, though. You do this because you love teaching.
I do, and that is my passion.
Which is where the name of your stuff came from was getting creative. Jan didn't want to be in one box.
Jan says she would like a studio tour while you're here.
You can have one, Jan. It's very technical. It'll be a bit boring for many people, but I can show it to you.
Yeah, I was just checking the chat there. Hi, Jane. Good to see you. I hope you feel better very soon. Thanks for popping in, Jane.
Anything else you have planned or you want to tell them about?
Yeah, I have a couple of memory books that use letters. And I'm not going to show it to you or tell you much more about that, but they're books that use letters as the basis for the book. And it's a really cool way to pass memories along to other people. So I've got a couple of different ways of doing that. So yeah, that's coming up. And then also we're going to do a class on how to create a treasure box that's done with fabric and fibers and stuff. And that'll be It's really going to be fun. Something that everybody's will be completely different from each other. So that's going to be fun to do. And then we just finished the mandala course. So I just have that all finished. That's going to be available pretty soon. And again, anyone can take those courses. You want to grab those mandalas?
Yeah, tell them what a course is again.
A course is a whole bunch of classes that are about one subject. So this is going to be about mandalas, and you guys know, if you've been watching me any length of time, you know that that is one of the things I absolutely love to do, and I can't wait to show you some things. Claus Man even got into making mandalas. I'm telling you, before he leaves, the technical department leaves, he might be doing a mandala too.
Never know.
I know. He'd be really good at it. They're both excellent at it. So anyway, the mandala course takes you from not knowing anything about a mandala, and then we have 12 or 13 classes plus a bonus class, and it will take you step by step through all different kinds of materials and mediums and different styles of mandalas, and we're going to have some mandala maps and all different kinds of things, and we'll wind up at the very last class putting it all together, and we're going to end up having... This is one of the final projects here. So this is one of the final projects. Can you see? I never have been good about left and right, up and down when it comes to this.
It's a little hard.
Race always tells me, closer to your nose or further away. You know, that helps as much as anything. So this is the final project. This is not the bonus project. The bonus project is in fabric, which is really fun. And So anyway, that's where the mandala course will end up and headed toward that.
Right. And so part of that is so that they know it's all done and recorded and finished.
Yes.
I've been a bit busy and I'm required to put it on the website and get it all done and get past all the technical stuff. So that's my responsibility. So you've done what you need to do. It's mine now. My time to put it on the site.
Right. So that's what we're doing now. My part's done. We got to get him fired up when he has the chance to get that part done. So we don't have an exact date for when it will go live, but it's coming up here before too long.
It's coming. I'll still be traveling in this month up until about the middle of the month. So, you know, as soon as I get back and settled back into Los Angeles, then it'll start getting up.
Yeah.
Yeah, start getting up.
So that's coming before long. And then after, to kind of go along with that, we have one book on mandalas called Mandala Melange, which is available at HowToGetCreative.com in the shop. And that's a whole book of mandalas that you can use in whatever way you'd like to use them. You can color them, you can shrink them, you know, you can use them for on canvases. You can do anything you want to.
They can download them and print them at home.
Right. It's an ebook, and so you just print them out, and there's 25 different patterns that I drew that are my creation in there. And so that's called Mandala Melange. Well, we've got another book that will be coming out that uses patterns based on the mandala, the upcoming mandala course, which is probably going to be called, well, in fact, I know it's going to be called Mandala Madness, because I'm mad about mandalas. Let's just be frank about it, you know? And so I'm not the only one. Patty in the chat is mad about mandalas too. I know that for a fact, because she has tweeted many, many, many of her beautiful mandalas to me that are stunning. So, hi, Shu. Did I see Shu was here? Yeah, Shu's here. She's from India.
Wow. Hi, Shu.
I know.
Welcome.
Amazing. Yeah. Michelle says, well, hurry up, race.
I know, right?
Shirley S. loves mandalas too.
So the mandala course, the mandala course doesn't require the book, but if you want the patterns, you can download them, you can get them.
Right. So it's a whole...
You can do them at home, or if you want them to be already done, you can just download them.
Yeah. So it's kind of a... You don't have to have one to do the other.
No.
But we will have a second book available. So that's coming. And then we decided to do something really fun we've been working on. And this is really cool. We're going to do... Are you ready for this? You know my love of cards, because you guys have been here to see them. Inspiration cards. Because I have a stack that must be, you know, like this tall of decks of inspiration cards and prompt cards and that kind of thing. We're going to do a mandala inspiration deck. And so we've been working on that. And it's not going to be your ordinary... ordinary is not the right word. It's not going to be exactly like the format of other cards that are out there right now. We're kind of changing it up, tweaking it a little bit. So, yeah, so that's coming.
That'll be kind of fun, too.
That's
the first
great.
Time that we've done a physical product for you.
Yeah, yeah.
So, that's again, it's really not cool. Required to do it, you know, but if you want it, you can grab it and you can pick it up. And they'll be fun. They'll be really nice quality and on the level of artistic quality.
Yeah.
So that's good. It'll be fun.
So that's coming. And, what do you think? Okay, I'm out of breath.
Is there anything else you want to do?
What do you guys think of that so far? Do you think that that's going to be, Nikki Beauty Bliss wants to know how much is the course? Don't have a price set yet. It's coming.
It'll be comparable to the other courses that are out there.
Yeah.
They'll be close to the same price. It's on the membership site. If you look up, miningyourmuse.com, that'll take you to one of our courses right now. Mm-hmm. And you can look at that one. And if the price will be really similar. We haven't set a final price, but it'll probably be the same, most likely.
Could be.
Never know.
Could be. Never mind, Barb. Shut up.
You never know. It's going to be a good value.
Sometimes my brain just goes on hold, so we should just move on, right? Okay, Jess, that's a really good question, Jess. Jess wants to know that she says the mandala book has mandalas in it, and do I have an angel policy if you want to use them on greeting cards? Yes, here is my angel policy. Once you buy the book, You may use them on cards. You may use them in your artwork. You may do whatever you'd like to do. You bought the book. You have the information. The only thing that the only exception to that rule is that you can't repackage them in your own book. Take my drawings and repackage them in your own book and sell them as your own stuff. That's the only stipulation. But my angel policy is you bought it, you use them. You know, if you can put them on greeting cards and make money selling your greeting cards, because Jess does wonderful greeting cards, yeah, go for it. Go for it. Marion wants to know if I've started on my 500 journaling prompts book. Well, no, haven't done that.
That's a good idea, Jess.
No, that was Marion that came up with that
one. I can't see it. Marion, I haven't seen it yet.
Yeah, no, that hasn't happened yet.
Maybe one day. Right now, we're going to get all this stuff out of the way.
Yeah.
And moving on to the next season and making sure that the Friday streams keep going and everything mm-hmm. is getting better for everybody. Mm-hmm. And that's the plan.
Yeah. And if they have, if you guys have things that you want to see, you know, whether it's on stream or if you are a member at HowToGetCreative.com and you have classes that you want to see or further explore, you're always welcome to contact me and offer suggestions. You can put them in the description box below the video that you're watching right now. You can contact me on Twitter at Barb Owen Designs. If you're a member, you can contact us through filling out a support ticket on the website. So you can do that. So there are multiple ways. You can always get in touch with me.
Yeah, lots of ways to get in touch. And we're hoping... We're hoping that at sometime, 2017 or 18, people will be able to see you in person somewhere.
Oh, yeah, that is true. Yeah.
So we want to be able to get you or find a way for you to be someplace mm-hmm. where people can see and meet you and do some other fun stuff.
Do some live classes.
And some live classes in person. Nothing's planned yet, but we're hoping that that's a...
Would you guys like that
in the schedule.
Would you guys like that? To actually do an in-person kind of thing?
That might be kind of fun.
Hey, Joyce Rigby. Good to see you. Joyce Rigby is, haven't seen her in a long time. This is the technical department right here. Yep.
Who was that asked?
Joyce Rigby. She's in the UK.
Hi, Joyce. I think I've talked to you on our support stuff.
She wants to know.
Emails.
Probably have. She wants to know if I'm coming to London.
You never know, Joyce. Do you have a good place?
Here we go. We're supposed to come to India, Nashville.
That's a good idea.
Israel.
Make suggestions. Where are we going to go? So far we have London, India, Nashville, Israel.
Yeah. Europe.
Alabama. Yep. All kinds of different places.
Yep.
And a world tour. Canada.
World tour. That sounds fun.
World tour. That might be kind of fun.
I think we should go to Australia and New Zealand,
too. I like that.
Doesn't that sound like fun?
Nikki Beattie Bliss wants you to go to Brentwood, California, where she lives and where I live.
Nancy says, when will you do the inspiration deck? And is it on here or a class? The inspiration deck, the mandala inspiration deck will be available on the website, but anybody can purchase it.
Yep.
So that's open to anybody.
Yeah,
and we'll play with it here on stream. So we'll be experimenting and playing with the cards here too.
Yeah. Yeah. It'll be one of your first things that you make physically.
Yes. And probably as soon as I get one of my hot little hands, we will do a stream right here and be playing with it.
Yeah.
So I'll show you how to use them and stuff. All right.
There's nothing else on the list. Yeah. I mean, I've monopolized the first part of your stream here. Most of it.
You ready
actually.
To do some art now?
No, I guess.
Yeah. No. No, he's probably not. He's probably going to weasel out of it, and he's probably going to take off. And I probably should excuse him, don't you think?
Right. May I be excused, please?
You may.
All right. So do some streams and some creative stuff.
Yeah, I will.
All right. Bye, everybody. It was nice seeing you and talking to everybody.
Thank you.
You bet.
I love you.
Love too.
I'm so glad you're here.
Yeah, I'm glad I'm here, too.
I know.
All right. Have a good stream. Right, enjoy your creative stuff.
All right. See you later.
See ya.
All right. All right. We got him here for a little bit, all the way from LA. I know you guys want to see him do art, but yeah, he's not I knew that was pushing my luck. I knew that was pushing my luck way too hard. Okay, so I have absolutely nothing planned because here's what I've been doing. My life for the last week has been cleaning the house, organizing the space, getting ready for people and cooking, and then traveling to go pick him up at the airport in Kansas City. So I have had no time in this period of time to plan what we're going to do today. So I am going to ask you, what would you like for me to do today? Now, we can't do something that's going to last like hours and hours and hours. So, you know, let's be reasonable, but I'm open to suggestions. What do you want me to do? Let's see. Christy appreciates the cooking. I love doing that for the people that I love. I absolutely do. And so I am not complaining by any means. No complaints. I am thrilled to have everyone here and get to spend time with them and be in the same space with them. It just, you know, when I spend all of my time here physically in the studio working, everything else tends to kind of fall apart a little bit. Let's just be honest about it. Yeah, it does kind of tend to fall apart. So when it's time to get it all back together, it takes a little effort. The ugly woman, no. You guys, honest to God, want me to paint that ugly woman? Paste paper was a suggestion. Paste papers? Let's do paste papers. I saw that a couple times. Song and dance. Sure, cat. Let's do some paste papers, shall we? Let's do that. I'm not painting that ugly woman. I am not painting. You cannot make me paint that ugly woman. You cannot. You want to do paste papers? Krissa wants big tags. All right, how about if we do some paste paper and tags? And whatever. We'll play with that. Sound okay? No glitter. No glitter. Nope. All right. Hang on, you guys. I will let you... I'll give you a mandala to look at for a minute while I get the paste paper stuff. How's that? All right. So everybody be good for a minute and talk to each other. And I'll get some paste paper stuff set up. We'll do that. Because I can set up the paste paper stuff relatively quickly. Let me show you this, too. This is a really fun journal. Let me put that here. I'll show you that in a second, too. Okay, I'm pulling out colors of paint. I'm getting it together. Talk amongst yourselves. Look, Krissa, I found big tags. Okay, here we go. (Clears throat) Don't traumatize Nikki about the cat. She's already traumatized enough. Hi, Eileen. Good to see you. Okay, so here is, I wanted to show you this book that I found. Collage This Journal by Eleanor Shakespeare. This is really a fun, this is a little bit on the order of like the Wreck This Journal book. It has really cool stuff in it. Very mixed media looking. But you do things like this. Do you ever wish you could bottle a moment? And you find images that you can put in the different things. And like this one at the beginning, collage your portrait using lots of different photos of yourself in here. What would fall out of your time capsule in 100 years? Tell the story of your favorite record. Create falling leaf shapes of things you want to leave behind. Isn't that cool? Need a helping hand? Got a lot on your mind? Fill the heads with stuff. What does your future hold? Collage yourself as a superhero. What would your powers be? Collage a home video of your happiest memories. I'm just going through a few of these. Fill this room with your fears, phobias, and things you hate. I may skip that page. Excuse me. Create signs using good advice you've received. Be kind, relax, work hard. That'll be a fun page. What nourishes you? How much do you have in common? So you and them, what do you have in common? What hand have you been dealt? Who or what makes your heart sing? And use photos, document how you've changed over time. Oh, that could be enlightening. What do you see when you look in the mirror? What would you like to understand more clearly? What makes you feel better? Create a secret den. What would you see through the keyhole? Doesn't this look like a fun book? Yeah, so you can get that. I found it at the bookstore, local bookstore. So, very cool. Love this. All right. Okay, you guys want paste paper. Let's do it. So you can do paste paper a variety of ways. I choose to mix it up because it's easy with Elmer's Art Paste. Some people use Elmer's glue. Some people use liquid starch. Some people use wallpaper paste. There are a couple of classes that I have, full-length classes here on YouTube and also on the website that detail what I do with paste paper, how I mix it up, and all that kind of stuff. So I'm just going to put some of the already pre-mixed liquid in. I use this little ice cube tray that a friend sent me one time, which I really appreciate because it's really been great to use. And then I just use cheap acrylic paints. I know, doesn't it have great ideas in it, Shu? Absolutely. So put in some, and I don't do this as an exact science. Dorothy says, my mantra, I don't need any more books. I don't need any more books. Dorothy, of course you do. Everybody needs books. You can never have too many books. So I'm just shaking up the acrylic paints. These are craft paints. I rarely ever use anything much more exciting than craft paints. And I don't use an exact formula as to how much paint I put in there. I squirt some in and mix it up and see how it paints out. If it paints out really well, I consider myself lucky. And if it doesn't, I adjust it either with more paint or more of the paste material. So I'm putting a color in each compartment, and then I just use little ice cream, popsicle, whatever, craft sticks, and mix up the colors. So what the art paste does is it does this weird thing to paint. It kind of thins the paint, but it also kind of helps it hold its shape. You can transform ugly papers, cardstock, ugly scrapbook paper. You can do some amazing things with paste, the art paste, and you can make beautiful papers. I love having them on hand. And you can do, like I showed you a second ago, we're going to do some of these great big art tags. I love having my own tags to use in different projects. And the paste liquid and the paint combine really quickly. All right, so we've got these mixed up, and I just chose some random colors. And you do need to have space when you do this. This is a little bit like jelly plate printing in that you need room. So I think we'll just work on these tags because I really didn't set up for this, and so we'll just work on these tags because then I won't have to have quite as much room. How's that sound? These are giant tags. I don't know if they still make these. These are giant tags, the number 12 size in Manila. So I don't even know if they still make these, but that's the first thing I saw, so we'll do these. These make nice little books or cool little book covers. So let's play with them. I didn't mix the red. I think I did, but it kind of settled out. Maybe not. The metallics, you have to mix them again as you go. So they settle out right away. Okay. And I usually use one foam brush per color. So I just stick them in. Muppet, my delightful little dog, decided... She is such a good girl, and the other day she decided to chew up my foam brushes. When I wasn't looking, and she chewed up several of my good foam brushes. I'm like, you little rat. Yeah. Bad dog. Okay, so I just put a foam brush in each color. Okay, so here we go. So we have the tag. And so we're just going to start out and put some of the paint mixture. And I might do a couple of colors. Like so. And then you need some texture tools. So one of my favorites is this. This is the Catalyst Wedge. And then you can use other things too. Like you can use these, anything that makes a mark. Okay, and so then you can call that your first layer of color, like so. So we did that. And then I just set it aside and let it dry. It does take some time for this to dry, and the cardstock or the paper will wrinkle up and warp and do all that kind of stuff. But then it eventually settles out somewhat, but sometimes you end up having to kind of manipulate the paper to get it completely flat. And then after it's dry, then you can do more colors. And the more layers that you add onto it, the more complex the paste paper becomes. And that's what's cool. So what I'm doing is just bending it to kind of get some of the warp to stop. Flatten it a little bit. We'll set it aside and see what it does. And then wipe up. Yeah, well, I got mad at that cute little face, let me tell you. She's usually so good. And that night, she decided she's going to just do her own thing. And she never gets into my stuff. That's what was such a surprise about it. You know, she just doesn't get into things that don't belong to her. She's always been a really good girl. That night, she was definitely not. And she made a mess. She not only chewed up the foam brush, she splintered the wood. Absolutely splintered the wooden handles to a million pieces. So I am not picky about this. I don't stress out over it. I just do some stuff and then I come back later and add another layer of color on it. And sometimes you see all the colors here and most of the time you just see bits and pieces. All right, so there's that one. So again, I'm just gonna kind of twist it a little bit to get it to flatten out a little bit. Well, you know, Joyce, here's my thought about that. Joyce says she hopes she didn't get splinters in her mouth. I kind of felt like if she got a splinter in her mouth, she deserved it. Now, what do you think of that? How's that for being mean? Yeah, how's that for being mean? And I love that little Henri dog. But she ticked me off that night. Not that the brushes are expensive by any means. She was just being her. You know, it just so surprised me. A big surprise. The less you think about this, the better. You know, you just make marks and then just see what happens. So to me, that's the best part about doing this stuff. And I don't know how well you can even see that because the colors are pretty light. But I just drew swirls in the paste. But you see how it holds. You can't thin the paint down and get it to do that. But this will hold the design until it's dry. Deborah says Chance and Charlie made her do it. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Hey, CB. Okay, we'll play with a couple of rubber stamps. Sometimes the thing with rubber stamps works for me. Sometimes it doesn't. So we'll see if it's going to work today. And you can even do stuff like this and just let it dry. You don't have to put any design in it if you don't want to. But I love making the paste papers. I love having an assortment of them on hand. Let's put some pattern in it first. You can get very, very picky about the designs and the way you do them. I don't, you know. So I'm just picking paint up off the surface. And I don't think you guys can see that, but it does give it a little bit of texture here and there. And here's the other thing. Let me show you this too. If you're doing paste paper like this and you do it and you don't like it, just take your brush and just paint over it. So we'll just paint this out just so you can see that's how you can do it. Metallics work really nicely. Any kind of acrylic paint works really well with this. So let's just say that you didn't like that. So you just do that. And we'll try it just with the stamp. Okay, that's better. So we'll do that. And then you can use your texture tools and add texture in between. So that seems to be more effective. And you can also paint with your fingers. You can work with cotton swabs. You can do all different kinds of tools. I mean, it's just literally try it and see if it works. I very regularly have people ask me if XYZ thing will work for a given technique. And my standard answer is try it and see what happens. Because you just, you know, sometimes you don't know how something's going to work. You can't know in advance. That's what I'm trying to say. You just have to do it. Yeah, that circle stamp is really a cool stamp. That is an old one from Ranger. That was one of the Claudine Helmuth stamps. I'll show you the ones that I have that are from her. These are not available, so take a look at them, and you may be able to recreate something similar yourself. Because these are no longer available. I think this was also one of them. They're really nice stamps. I was very sad when they discontinued them. And if you can still get these someplace, if somebody knows if you can still get them, let me know in the chat. I think that's all of them. No, here's another one. But you can do these, you can make these yourself with fun foam. And these are just glued on plastic, like acrylic plastic. So all of these are her stamps, Claudine Helmuth stamps, that were produced with Ranger. So these are not the only ones she had. These are the ones that I have. And these all work really well for doing paste paper type stuff or on the jelly plate or on fabric. I use these on fabric stamps, you know, for fabric things. Can you dry the paste paper? Ilona wants to know if you can dry them with the heat gun. And yes, you can, but I end up doing so many in one shot that I'll do, you know, a whole bunch of papers. And by the time I get done with, you know, like 20, 30, 40 papers, the first ones are dry. So I tend not to use the heat gun, but you could if you wanted. So Dorothy says, phew, something she doesn't need to buy. She's already got them. Good for you, Dorothy. That's cool. Okay, so we'll move those out of the way. I use these actually more commonly when I'm painting fabric than anything else, but I do love them. Okay, let's go back and make a couple more tags. How many do I have here? I have three more, so we'll do these three. And I tend to use the same colors of, you know, mix up whatever colors. Like I might do 10 or 12 colors of paste paint And then I'll use all of those, you know, and do that whole bunch of paper with those colors. And then the next time I do another bunch of paste papers, I'll use completely different colors, or try to remember to do different colors. All right, so I really like this wide spacing of these teeth, shall we call them? Okay, so I'm just going to let that do its thing. So that was just one single color. So we'll just let that do its thing here. So we'll do these other two, and then we'll go back and see if we can, if the first ones aren't dry, then we'll dry them with a heat gun, and we'll add another color and see what we can do. You really do want the first layer to be dry before you add subsequent layers. Otherwise, you just kind of defeat the purpose of the whole thing. And I use these paste paper, whether it's on cardstock or text paper. You can do colored paper. Like if you've got a whole bunch of colored paper that you don't like, you can use that. You can do it on colored paper. You can do it on colored cardstock. It's just a great way to alter papers, for one thing. So I'm just stamping into it, and this is not showing up on camera. I really should have chosen darker colors for you guys to see it very well. Once this dries a little bit, I'll show you on the other camera a little bit more. All right, and we got one more left. They really are awesome stamps, aren't they, Kat? I mean, they just really are. I love the designs of them. The quality is good, and they weren't expensive, you know, which was, it's always nice to find something that doesn't cost an arm and a leg, huh? All right, how about, let's just, and then let's do this. When you're doing stuff like this, you just can't have a preconceived idea, in my opinion, and somebody may disagree with me. I just don't think you can have a preconceived idea of what you want it to end up to be like. Okay, and then, but you see how it's holding its shape, how the paint is holding its shape, and it will dry just like that. That's one of my favorite, very favorite things about this. Okay, so clean up this a little bit. We'll see if anything from the first, I've got the heater turned off, the furnace turned off in my studio space, so it's not exactly toasty in here. So let's hit this with a heat gun a little bit. Hi, Rhonda. Now, Rhonda, you need to refresh. Somebody tell Rhonda to refresh. Okay, this is not super super dry, but I think it's dry enough to use. So let's go over the top of it with another color. And you can use a single color or you can use multiple colors. It just, you know, pretty much depends on what you want to do. And the colors change as they dry. So it's one of those things you can't judge what it's going to look like when you... Because I've made some that I thought, that's the ugliest thing I've ever seen in my life. And then I let it dry and I go, where was that ugly one I did? Okay, so let's do... let's go this way. And then we'll take a little, I forgot the name of these, style sticks. Take a style stick and add a little bit more style. Now you can't mess around with this too long. If you do, once this paint and paste mixture starts drying, it will not move on you. So you have to move somewhat quickly when you do this. Because once it starts setting up, you're done. It's over. You'll just have to wait for the next color. Okay? So we're going to set this one aside, let it dry, then we'll take a look at it. Okay, here's another one. Let's dry it a little bit. It's probably my voice, Eileen. I tend to put people to sleep. Ruth is going into lurking mode. Huh. All right, Ruth. Have a nice nap. Let's put another color on this one and just kind of bend the paper a little bit to kind of get it to cooperate with you. Let's do, how about purple? This will wake Ruth up. She'll be back. When she sees me using purple, she'll be back. Now, if you think you've gone too far, you know, you do a layer and you go, oh, I shouldn't have done that, then just put something else over the top of it. Don't stress out about it. You can't worry. It's just like when you're jelly plate printing, you can't worry about the result. You just can't worry about it. You just have to just see how it turns out. And again, as I said, you can't dilly-dally around with it too long, because if you do, it stops reacting. So you can't pick up the paint, you can't move it. Okay, so I don't know how much of that you can see, but you can see how it's picked up some of the paint, and then you get to see the colors below it. All right, we're going to let that sit. let's go to this one. And also, you're going to end up with paste, paint, and stuff all over the back of whatever you're doing, so don't don't try to save the back of it. If you want to add something else to the back, that's fine, but you're not going to save it and keep it pristine on the back, because it just doesn't work that way. Marion's trying to mix her paste paint. Cool. So normally I do many more sheets than I'm doing here. That's why I don't have to use the heat gun on it. But as you can see, it's working. And I think this was the one you guys said you really liked. Like, oh, you really like this one? See, I will not let that stay that way. Even though it looks cool, I will put more layers on top of this. So, because I like the depth of the layers of color. And if you get a spot that's just like too wet, then dab it up. Yeah, the stamps are discontinued. Yeah, they are. But that's why I showed that big shot of them for a while, so you could take a screenshot of them, you know, and get some ideas. I wouldn't suggest that you copy them exactly, because that's not exactly fair to the artist. But at the same time, I don't think you probably could exactly copy them totally. And but to get inspiration from them, since they are discontinued, you know, I don't see a big problem with that personally. If you do see a problem with it, just don't do it. So, just adding some more paint. And it does help if you mop up the stuff that's on the mat. As you're going, that does help control some of the mess that gets on the back. You will get it on your hands, but it is, as messy projects go, this is one of the lesser messy projects. And as I was saying earlier, you can be very, very meticulous about these designs. I mean, most of the people who, from the old days, when they would do these designs, they would be very, very meticulous, and they would do these patterns so perfectly. That is so not me. So I don't do it that way, you know? You know what I mean? Okay, so there we got another one. So this is a second layer, so you can see it that way. Okay, this one's not dry yet. See, I'm working too fast for them to get dry. Let's see if we can get three of these. Well, I've got four. Maybe we can get all four of these dry. Yeah, the serendipity, it is great. But see how you get the stuff all over the back? That's just the way it is. You just get stuff on the back of them. And you can add more layers of paste paint on this side, or, you know, I don't mind if it looks like that for most of the kinds of things that I do. I kind of enjoy seeing the results. Sorry about my voice. I've been talking a lot, and so my voice is a little it's a little shop worn, shall we say. The texture of the paste paint is a little, it's not as gritty as coarse, clear gesso. It's not that gritty, but it does have a certain coarseness to it. But this is one of the best ways that I know of to transform ugly scrapbook papers. You know, some that you'll never use again in your life. It's a great way to do that. Not that I would have anything like that, but you know. The metallics are really nice to use in the paste papers. You get some looks with metallic paint that you just don't get any other way. Okay, so those are dry enough that, let's go back to this one. This was the first one I started with, so we'll go back to that one. I think it was the first one I started with. Maybe not. I don't know. All right, let's do, and I'm just working with the same colors of paint. I'm not adding any other colors. Which there's no reason that you couldn't add more colors, but I'm just using the same colors that I started with to begin with in the beginning. You can work with complementary colors, which can be a little tricky. You just want to dry them between applications, but you can get some really beautiful, like blue and orange. Beautiful paste papers, but just dry between the colors. Okay, so let's do now, this, you have to really look at it to be able to see the stamp is still under there. But it is. This where we stamped it and pulled it off, that's still under there. But it's like it buries, each successive layer of paint buries the previous layer, the previous image. It just kind of like sinks it down below the, it's almost like, I think of it almost like water. It just sort of puts it down below the surface. Use it on the ugly woman. Paste paper wouldn't even help that broad. Paste paper would not help that broad. Mm-mm. You guys and that ugly woman, honestly. One day I'm going to have to paint her. You'll know the day that I paint her, you'll know that I absolutely am out of any positively any creativity. There's not one creative bone left in my body. That's the day I paint the ugly woman. Right? That's right. Okay, so now you can see again how the layers are beginning to build. The colors are beginning to meld together. Okay, this is another one that had the stamps on it that we stamped. You can kind of see the image as I tilted in the light. You can see the stamped image here. Well, the ugly woman is a wood carving, that my husband created, and she's truly so ugly that they keep teasing me about painting the ugly woman. She's a wood carving. You can almost say that it's a she, but, you know, it's almost in question as to what gender she really is. But we keep calling her a she because she seems to have some anatomy that might indicate she might be a woman. She's pretty ugly. She's pretty ugly. They even started a Kickstarter campaign or a GoFundMe or something to save the ugly woman. Nothing's going to save that thing. She is too ugly for words. Okay, now. Over here in this little section right here, the paint was too dry, so I couldn't get it to do anything. So that'll just either live like that, or I'll come back and add another color over it. Okay, so this is going to make some of you unhappy because you like this one. However, it needs more color on it. So take a good look at it because it's going to go away. That could be it, Dorothy. Dorothy says that she might not know what gender she is. That's so true. Okay, so let's go for this one. So take a good look at it because it's going away. Everybody got a good look? Okay, here it goes. And the longer the paint sits and the less there is in the container, the quicker it starts drying also. Okay, so there is the result now with another layer on it. You can still see the design underneath, but it has begun to sink below the surface. I like that far better, personally. And since I'm the one doing it, guess what? I win. Hi, Sandra. Oh. Miriam says she'll put her dogs to work to buy the ugly woman if I paint her. I believe you. Mm-hmm. Almost. I believe you almost. Okay, let's put one more layer of color on this one. I'm going to come back and dry it. Oh, Miriam says she sold a painting from the art show. That's wonderful. Good for you. That must be a great feeling. And I may mix up one more color of paint here in gold, just to show you. How the gold really changes the pieces. I'm trying to multitask. I'm trying to dry one and get more paste paint mixed up This could be disastrous. Could be. I'm going to try it. I'm multitasking here. So, art paste. And gold craft acrylic paint. Okay, it seems pretty dry. Okay, let's mix this up. The metallics do settle out, and so you have to kind of remix them every time you dip into them, because they will look like they're not mixed at all, and then you go, yeah, I mixed that. You know, that's just the nature of what they do. Okay, so let's add some gold to some of these and see what we get. And the papers do continue to curl. So you kind of have to manipulate them a little bit. And I'm really pushing how quickly I'm adding these various layers. So, you know, we'll see how it works. I normally let them get pretty bone dry in between additions of color. You can tell I'm not being terribly careful about how I put the paint on. Okay, let's just go like this. Okay, so do you see how, now I know you can't see the dried gold on here yet, but do you see how cool that is? You get all those different layers coming up through all the other layers. So when this is fully dry, you will get some of the most interesting effects. All right, let's do this one. This one has gold or purple metallic on it already, so this could be a very pretty one with gold and purple. I'm not going to put gold on all of them, just on, maybe one more after this. But you see what I mean? If you get a layer that you don't like, let it dry, put another color on it, and I'm going to tell you that sometimes the ugliest ones turn out to be your very favorite papers. Nope, that's not enough to reveal anything, so we'll just wipe that back out. Okay, so again, this one's going to be very kind of pastel looking, but you just get the coolest effects from that gold and from the multiple layers. All right, let's do one more here. I got to really dry this one because it's really wet. Normally don't sop up the excess, I just let it dry, but in the interest of having it where you can have a shot at seeing what I'm doing, we're going to soak up the excess, which didn't seem to hurt it. Okay, it's dry enough. Let's go for a gold layer. So you can see just by adding the gold how it's tinted the color, taking the color in a different direction, which is cool. But you can still see it. All right, let's go. And then I think that's all I'm going to do to that. Because this one, the colors are very strong underneath, but that layer of gold on the top, again, changes the tone of it, which is fun. All right, let's do one more. Let's see, how dry is this? Not quite dry. Let's hit this with a heat gun just a little bit, and then we'll do this one. But I do love the metallic paints on them. Hi Tam, nice to see you. And anybody that I miss saying hello to, I'm so glad you're here. Thanks for spending your day. And Yarlin, where are you from? Nice to have you here, all of you. And boy, I don't know how to say, is it Kiat? That's a very interesting name. Q-Y-H-A-T. Very pretty name. Okay, so we got gold on this one. Let's see what we're gonna do here. Let's go with one of these. Good enough. Okay, calling it done. All right, let me move this stuff out of the way. Then I'm gonna clean up just a second, and then we'll take a look at them with my other camera that will show them to you just a little differently. Okay, we'll take a look at them. Now, they're wet, so they'll change. They will continue to change until they're fully dry. But here we go. Okay, so you can see it's very wet as it's shiny. When it's shiny, it's very wet. But that will give you the look. Mara says, do the sponge tools hold up well? They do for a long time, as long as you clean them. As long as you clean them out. These style sticks that I'm using here, if you have access to Amazon, you can get them on Amazon. They come in wedges and they come in round. Pardon me, round tips as well as the wedges. Most of your craft stores are going to have them also if you have access to a local craft store. Okay, so this is going to have to dry, but you can see the layers below. So you can see the stamping is in there. You can see the various layers of stamping. You can see the other colors below with the various patterns and so forth. So there's that one. Okay, here's another one. This one had where I drew big swirls in the paint in the beginning. So I just drew big old swirls in it. You can see them. And then there are several other colors and coats of paint. All right, here's another one. This one is probably one of the tamer ones. This probably needs at least one more color on it. But the complexity comes from the different layers and doing different things to the layers of paint. All right, here's this one. This one is really more effective when you look at it this direction. So you look at it that way. Or you can look at it this way. It has a completely, you know, different appearance. All right, and this one. Jan wants me to come to Quail Hill. Wouldn't that be fun? Who knows? You never know. Bye, Tam. Kat says, I didn't think I'd like what Barb is doing now, but I'm happy to see she changed my mind. And then as you tip them around in the light, I'm not sure I'm going to be able to catch it, but the metallic begins to show up as you tip it in the light. You can see the metallic paint. Of course, it's not dry, so it's not a fair comparison, but anyway, you can see what's going on there. Here's another one. If you haven't tried paste paper, I highly recommend that you do. And here's the last one. This one's really wet, but you can kind of see the reflection of the gold. Doing paste paper and jelly plate printing are some of my all-time favorite things to do to create my own papers. And yeah, I love it. Love them. So thanks for asking me to do that today. That was fun. Let me move these out of the way. We're going to get the sponsors out and call it a day. And these paste papers make great book covers. They make great pages for books. If you take a look at the paste paper classes that I have on YouTube or on the website, they are the same classes. We put a series of, I think it was 12 classes on YouTube that are the same things as we have on the website so people can understand what kinds of classes we do. So the paste paper pizzazz and paste paper is fabulous or something like that are the two that are either on YouTube or on HowToGetCreative.com. If you take a look at those, you'll see some projects where I've used the paste paper so you can really see what I've done with them. So let me get rid of the wet paint. We do not need sponsors and wet paint in the same location, right? And we'll let them come out. They're drunk in the sunshine at the moment. So we'll see if they want to come out. Oh, there you are. There you are. Come here. Oh, come here. What are you doing? Huh? I thought you were in that sunshine soaking up the sun. Yeah, I thought you were soaking up the sun. You weren't. You were at the door waiting for me, weren't you? Mm-hmm. All right, Charlie, just a minute. Come here. No, just lay down. There you go. There we go. Got those sponsors. Whew. A lot of work, I'm telling you. These two are work. So we have all of our cats present and accounted for. This one, and that one. They are funny, aren't they? They are a pair. Well, thank you so much, everyone, for coming and spending your day with us. Your day, your afternoon, couple hours, however long it's been, couple hours. Thanks for coming and hanging out with us and finding out, you know, kind of 2016 review, 2017 plans and so forth, and getting to see the technical department live and in person. And I appreciate you being here. Thank you so much for hanging out with me and on another drama-free Friday. Yeah, no drama. It's always good. Thanks for being here, everybody. I hope you have a wonderful weekend. And I will see you back here again next Friday. I don't know what we're going to do, but I'll figure out something. Otherwise, you'll tell me what to do again, right? Otherwise, you'll just tell me what to do and we'll just go for it and see what we can do. So thanks so much for being here. I hope you have a wonderful weekend. And it's just great to see everybody and see all the different countries represented that come together in a creative environment. That is so great. All right. So remember to get creative today, because you know, it's easy. And I will see you next week. Have a good one, everybody. Bye for now.